B'siyata d'shmaya, we're going to learn Psachim Daf Kuf Yud. We're going to start 9 lines from the bottom of Daf Kuf Tes Amud Beis. Says the Gemara, and the Gemara takes us back to the Mishnah at the beginning of the Perek. Which means every single one of us has to drink 4 cups of wine, the Arba Kaisas, at the Seder table. As we've discussed previously, the cups have to be distributed appropriately, one for Kiddush, one at the end of the Agada, one Birchas HaMazon, and one for Halil. And that's 4 cases, we all know Arba cases. Says the Gemara, asks the Gemara, Heicha Metakni Rabbonon, how could the Chachomim tell us, Arba cases is a Chiyuv Mid Rabbonon, how can the Chachomim say that to make a gezeira, to make a mitzvah derabbanon, b'midi da'asi be'le de sakona, with something that could potentially be dangerous. V'atanya, did we not learn in a braisa? Lo yoichal odom, a person should not eat. Trei, 2 of a similar food. A pear, v'lo yishte trei, nor should he drink a pear, a two or an even number of the same drink. When a person, after relieving himself, he wipes himself clean, he shouldn't do it in pairs. And regarding meeting his needs in the marriage, he should make sure not to do things in pairs, as Rashi explains. The question is that this is a concept known as zugois, pairs. And there was a reason to believe that the mazikim, whether it's the demons or we don't really know what these things are, but there's mazikim that they attach themselves to anybody who does things in pairs. And the Rabbeinu Bachya in Shulchan Shel Arba explains what's behind it, that, you know, Klal Yisrael is all about Achdus, it's about there's one Rabbeinu Shleilem, not about two, because there are other beliefs who Chas V'Shalom believe that there are two powers in the world. So in order to undermine anyone who believes in pairs, then there's a concept called zugois, and doing things in pairs potentially could arouse the mazikim to harm the person. So the Gemara is asking, Arba kaisis is an even number. It's 2 sets. It's 2 pairs. How can the Chachomim say that you should drink 4 kaisis, risking people of getting harmed because of zugois? Omer of Nachman, Omar Kro, there's going to be a few answers. Rav Nachman answers that there's a special pasuk. The pasuk says, Leil Shmurim, that Pesach night is called a Leil Shmurim, a very much anticipated night. And what does it mean, the word Shmurim, besides so meaning that it's an anticipated evening? It means Leil HaMashumar, it is guarded, it's protected, there's a special divine protection from any mazikin. Mashumar Ubom in a mazikin, no demons, no external powers can have any influence over us on this night. Rava Omar. Rava gives another answer. Kois shel bracha. Since one of the 4 koises is Birchas HaMazon, considered a kois shel bracha, a number of times the Gemara has considered Birchas HaMazon as bracha. And since it's kois shel bracha, mitztarif letoiva ve'ene mitztarif lera'a, which means it combines with other cups only positively, not negatively. Which means if the total of all the cups that you drink is an odd number, then the cup is not going to be mitztarif. The cup of bracha, of Birchas HaMazon, will not combine to make it an even number, being a problem. That's called Eine Mitzarif Lera. And when a person drinks an even number of kaisis, and then there's an added kais of Birchas HaMazon, then it is mitztarif. It does combine to be considered as if he drank an odd number and is no longer a danger. Ravina Omer, a third answer, says the Gemara, that the Ravina says the 4 cups are actually not 2 sets or not a set of 4, which is an even number. It's 4 independent separate mitzvahs. Arba'a kase tikna rabbonon derech chirus. The Chachomim said that you should drink 4 cups in derech chirus, in the way that people who have just gone out from slavery to freedom with royalty, that's how they should drink the wine. Kol chad v'chad mitzvah ba'apei nafsha. Each one has its mitzvah ba'apei nafsha. Each one is an independent mitzvah. One of them is Kiddush, one of them is Birchas HaMazon, one of them is Halil, one of them is Haggadah. And since each one is an independent mitzvah, it's not considered as a single group of 4 or 2 groups of 2, and is considered as 4 individual kaisis, and there's no issue of zugois. says the Gemara, lo yasu tzrochov trei, regarding a person who's meeting his needs in speaking, as we said before, to do with the marital relationships, that one shouldn't do things twice. Says the Gemara, amai, why should it be that way? Nimlachu, we know that when a person has met his needs once, then his desire goes away, and that's it. If afterwards he chooses to do it again, then that just means he's made a new decision. He's Nimlach means he's changed his mind, as if to say, okay, I'm going to now start again. So it's twice one. It's not a double, it's not a pair, it's not a set, and therefore, why should there be an issue of Zugos? Omar Abaya, Abaya says, you're right. Hochikoma, this is what we meant to say before. Lo yoichal trei velo yishte trei. A person shouldn't eat in pairs, shouldn't eat the same food in pairs. Velo yishte trei, nor drink the same drink in pairs. Velo yaset srochov afilu pam achas. And if he did eat in pairs or drink in pairs, he should make sure not to be oiset srochov even just once. Why? Dilma cholish, because we know that a person who does tzrochov in this context, it very much weakens a person. Dil mecholish will become weaker. Umisra, and he will become harmed from it because of the zugais. That means being oiset tzrochov always weakens a person. Now that he's in a weakened state, he's more vulnerable. Since he's in a vulnerable state, make sure that you don't at the same time have an issue of zugais, which also makes a person vulnerable and also endangers a person. A vulnerable and weak person who's in a challenged situation and is in danger of the mazikim, that's even worse. Continues the Gemara, Tanu Rabbanon, we learnt in the Braisa, Shoisa Kiflaim, if somebody drinks a drink in doubles, in pairs, an even number of drinks, Domoi Baroishe, if he gets harmed, if he gets killed, it's as if he killed himself, because it's dangerous of the Mazikim, he shouldn't have done it. Omer Rav Yehuda, Rav Yehuda says, Eimosai, when is this true? Bizman Shelo Ro'o Pnei Ashuk. That's only if between the two cases he didn't see the marketplace, he didn't go out. Avol Ro'o Pnei Ashuk, but if he went out to see the marketplace, to see the streets outside, between the cases, Harushus B'yodo, he has permission to drink even in another case, even though it will be an even number. Omer Ravashi. Ravashi says, Chazino Leilu Rav Chanino, Rav Chananya Bar Bibi. We saw Rav Chananya Bar Bibi, the Akol Kasa, every cup that he would drink, have a nofik v'chozi apeshuke. He would go out and see the shuk, the marketplace, and that way he was staying safe from the mazikim. V'loy omron, and this that we said, that drinking in pairs or eating in pairs is a danger, is only elo lotzeis lederech. That's only if you afterwards plan to go on a journey, then these mazikim could hurt a person on the journey. Abul Babeso, if he's planning to stay in his home, loy, then there's no issue. Omer Abzeira. Abzeira says, V'lishon kelotzeis lederech. Somebody who goes to sleep is as vulnerable as somebody who's going on a journey, and the zugais could affect him. Kelotzeis lederech domi. Omer of Popper. Of Popper says, V'lotzeis lebeis akise, going out to excuse oneself, is kelotzeis lederech domi, is also similar to going out on a journey. That's the girus that we have in our Gemara. It seems from Rabbeinu Chananel, who says that going out to the Beis HaKisei, or going to sleep, are similar to Roya Pnei Ashuk, that if they do that, then Zugais will no longer be an issue. Says the Gemara, but Beisei Loi, is it true that if a person stays in at home, then he's not at risk of being hurt by these mazikim? V'harava, Rava, who was drinking, and he had no intentions of leaving his house afterwards, and nonetheless, Moni Kishurei, with every cup he would drink, he would count the beams. He would drink the first cup, he would look at one beam in his home. He would drink a second cup, he would look at the second beam. Every cup he was drinking, he would look at the next beam in order to keep count and make sure that he doesn't end off with an even number of drinks. V'abaya, and Abaya, we see him also. Kishosi chad kasa, when he would drink one cup, then mankitle ime, his mother, it wasn't really his mother, we've seen this a few times, but Rashbam brings it here from Kiddushin Daf Lamed Aleph. His mother actually passed away during childbirth, and this was the woman that treated him like his mother and looked after him. That when he would drink one cup, then his mother, so to speak, would hold trei kasa, two cups, betrei odeo, in her two hands, just in order that they shouldn't forget that Abaya shouldn't forget and just drink two cups. No, I've drunk one. Make sure if you're going to drink another one, it's going to be drinking another two. So you should be left with three koses, not with two koses. Rav Nachman by Yitzchok. Rav Nachman by Yitzchok, his custom was, ki avashosu terei kasi, when he would drink two cups, mankit le shomei, then the waiter or the one that was serving, the attendant, would hold chad kas, would hold another one in his hand in order to make sure that he wouldn't remain with two, he would have three. Chad kasa, and when Rav Nachman by Yitzchok would drink one cup, then mankit le, then his shamash would hold in his hand, terei kasa b'terei odei, two cups, one in each hand, again to make sure that he has three cups and not two. And here we're talking about Rav Nachman by Yitzchok and Rava, who they didn't have any intention of leaving the house, and nonetheless they were makbid. Did we not say that babayis, that if you're staying at home, there's nothing to be worried about? Answers the Gemara, Odom Choshev Shani, since they were very respected people and people who are very distinguished people, and the mazikim, Rashi says, the mosri shadim nafshayu la'azuke. The shadim got out of their way, their moise nefesh, in order to hurt the Talmidei Chachomim. And therefore, since they was an Odom Choshev, a prominent person, they had to be more careful. Continues the Gemara, Omar Ula. Ula said, Asara koisos, if somebody drinks 10 cups of wine, that means if he drinks 2, 4, 6, 8, that's an issue. You drink 10, there's no risk, there's no harm, there's no problem with zugois. And Ula Latame, this is Ula following his own opinion to Omar Ula. Some say Ula said this, some say it was in a braisa. Asora koisois tiknu babesa oval. The Chazal masakan that they would drink 10 cups of wine in the home of somebody who's mourning. And this is something disgusting. Subastav ches, viisal kadaitach. If you're going to say that that even drinking 10 cups has an issue of zugois because it's an even number, how could the Chachomim make such a gzeira, such a takona, that they should do something that could be dangerous? And therefore it must be that 10 cups is never a danger. But 8 or 6 or 4 or 2, yesh ben mishum zugois, there is nonetheless an issue of zugois. That's the opinion of Ula. Rav Chisda v'Rabbi Bar Rav Huna, and they lived a generation after Ula, they were more lenient. And Omri Tarvayu, they both said, Sholoim, since it says in the Brocha, in Birchas Kehanim, Yiso Hashem Pono Ve'Lecho V'Yosim Lecho Sholoim, the seventh word is Sholoim, where there's peace, no harm can befall anyone. Since it says, since seven is a concept of Sholim, therefore L'Toivo Mitztarif, L'Ra Loi Mitztarif. That means having a seventh cup, once you've had the seventh cup, that's it. That cup will always be Mitztarif to an even number creating an odd number, and it will never be Mitztarif to an odd number creating an even number. So any more than six koses is an issue, 8 koisos is not an issue. L'ra lo mitztarif, avol shito, but 6 cups, yesh ben mishum zugois. The Rav Chisda v'Rabba, they held 6 cups was still an issue. Rabba v'Rav Yosef, the next generation, they said, to Omri Tarvayu, no. They brought another posuk in Birchas Kehanim. It says in the posuk, Yoyer Hashem ponov elecho vichuneko. 5 words in the posuk. Vichuneko. Since vichuneko, chein is also a bracha, something which no mazik can harm, can come to harm when there's chen, and therefore the fifth kois is l'toivo mitztarif l'ra lo mitztarif. If you have cup number 5, it will always merge with an odd number. It will always merge with an even number creating an odd number, and will never merge with an odd number creating an even number. And therefore, having anything 7 cups and more is not 5 cups and more is not going to be an issue. Aval arba, but having 4 cups, yesh ben mishum zugois, there is an issue. Abaye v'Rava, d'omer tarvayu, they said even less, they were even more lenient. They said there's a pasuk, the beginning of Birchas Kehanim, where it says, Yivarechecho Hashem v'yishmerecho, the Shmira, 3 words in the pasuk. 3 is also something that protects us from danger. V'yishmerecho, l'toivo mitztarif, l'ra lo mitztarif, that a third cup will always be mitztarif to an even number, creating an odd number, and will never be mitztarif with an odd number creating an even number. And therefore, if even having any more than three cups will never be an issue. The only time there's a problem of zugois is two cups. V'az de Rava l'tameh, and this is Rava following his own opinion, de Rava afkinhu l'rabbonon, it was customary that the rabbonon, the chachomim, would give the talmidim, the rabbonon who were learning, that they would give them wine to drink, and Rava was accustomed to dismissing the talmidim, the chachomim, b'arba kaisis, even after having given them four kaisis. And if four was an issue of zugais, he wouldn't be able to do that, it would be dangerous. He's sending them on their journey. So since Rava would do that, Rava obviously held that only two cups is an issue, three and more is not an issue. And Rashbam already asked, also on Daf Kuf Tes Amud Beis, and also on Daf Kuf Yud over here on Amud Aleph, that if so, what was the issue that Rava had on Daf Kuf Tes Amud Aleph, that we learned that there was a problem with Arba Kaisis? What's the problem with Arba Kaisis? Rava said over there that you need the bracha. Rava says, Kaisel bracha mitztarif l'toiv einu mitztarif l'ra. Rava said it's only because one of the kaisis are birchas hamazon that there's no issue. According to Rava here, there's never an issue with more than two cups. Here we're having four cups. So that's the Rishonim. Discuss that here, and they say that we're soon going to see later that even though the regular zugais is not a problem, but they could nonetheless be a danger if there are sorceresses around, if there's kishuf around, and therefore the issue still applies somewhat. Continues the Gemara. Aval gav de itzik Rava bar Livoi, even though Rava bar Livoi, who drank four cups and he did get harmed, lo yichosh lo lemilsei, it didn't bother Rava, this was a Talmud of Rava, it didn't bother him that this Talmud, that means the fact that this Talmud got harmed, Rava didn't attribute it to the fact that he drank four kaisis. De Omar, he said, De Omar, Hahu mishum de oisvon bepirka hava. Rava said the reason that Rava bar Livoi got hurt, got punished, was because he would embarrass me by asking me questions against what I was saying in public. And it wasn't because he drank four cups. Continues the Gemara. Omer Rav Yosef. Rav Yosef says, Omer li Yosef Shida. There was this shade, a demon, or however you translate a shade, called Yosef, or Yosef, and Rav Yosef said that this shade told him that Ashmedai Malka de Shidei, the king of all the Shadim is called Ashmedai, and he's Munahu Akurhu Zuga. He is appointed and is in control of all the Zugais. That means all those Mazikim that would hurt people due to Zugais when they drink or eat Zugais, then he's the king of them. Umalka lo ikra Mazik. It's not appropriate for a king to be a Mazik. And therefore, there's no reason to be worried about Zugais, since they have a king above them. The king will make sure that all these powers or these Shadim will not hurt the people who drink or eat Zugais. Ika de Omer lo lahagi, so others say it differently. Adaraba. On the contrary, Malka raschonahu, a king is typically easily angered and he doesn't have any restraints or boundaries. May de boya ovid, whatever he wants he can do. Shamelech peretz geder, the pasuk says that a king can break open the fences, lasis lederech, to create for himself a path. Vein moichin beyodo, and nobody can protest against him. So on the contrary, being that there's a king there, it's even more dangerous. Omer of Papa. Rav Papa says, Omer li Yosef Shida. This Yosef Shade said to Rav Papa, betray Kotlinon. If it's a person that does things in pairs and does things twice, then the Mazikim will kill him. Barbo loy Kotlinon, Barbo Mazikinon. But if they do things four times, then they won't kill the person, but they will harm the person. Betraying, when a person does something twice, which is something which these mazikim would actually kill a person for, bein b'shogeg, bein b'mezid, irrespective of whether he drank or ate or did something twice, was intentional or unintentional. Barba, but when they harm people after doing something four times, it's only b'mezid in, they only do that when the person intentionally did something four times, b'shogeg, but if it was a mistake, loy, then not. Says the Gemara, v'yishtali, v'ikri, v'nofak. What happens if a person forgot? And it happened that he had zugais, and he went out on a journey. Now he's at risk. He's on the journey. He's had zugais. How can he protect himself? Maitakante, what can he do to protect himself? Answers the Gemara, Linkoid Zokfa de Yode de Yamina. He should take his right thumb, Beyode de Smoila, and hold it in his left hand. The Zokfa de Smoila, he should take his left thumb, Beyode de Yamina, and hold it in his right hand. The name Ahochi should say as follows, Atun, you, Vano, and I, Hotlosa, are three. We don't need to understand these things. We don't understand these things. This is just. It's a Gemara, it's called a lachash, it's something which you say to try and protect and to take away the power of these koichis hatuma, these mazikim. So a person should say there's you and me together is three, and then so to speak, he's said, right, we don't have an issue of zugos. V'yishamirle, if he hears a voice, irrespective, it doesn't matter what the voice is. Rashi says, even if it's the voice of a man or the voice of a woman, it doesn't matter. If you're hearing a voice that says, Atun va'ano ho arba, a response, what you said, you and I are three, you now hear an echo, so to speak, saying, you and I are four. Well, that's not good, because four is again a problem with zugos. Namely, you should answer back, Atun va'ano ho chamisho, I and you are five. V'yishamirle to Omar Atun va'ano ho shito. And if you hear a response saying, you and I are six, then namely, you should answer back, Atun va'ano ho sheva. You and I are seven. Hava uvda, there was an incident at Me'o v'chad. This went on from 2 to 4 to 6 to 8 until 100. That this poor fellow said, you and I are 99, and the voice answered back, you and I are 100. And then he says, you and I are 101. At that point, ad Me'o v'chad, till 101, and then from Merev Tsar, from the anguish of these mazikim, that they couldn't overpower him, upoka shido, this shade just burst, and could no longer harm the person. Continues the Gemara, Omar Ameimar, Omro li Rishtinhu denoshim kashfonios. The Rishtinhu is the woman in charge of the noshim kashfonios, the women who engage in witchcraft, possibly known as sorceresses. And this woman, who was in charge of all these women, told Ameimar as follows, Haiman de Pogabu, if you meet Benoshim Kashfonios, women who are engaging in witchcraft, Neimahochi, say to the women as follows, and again, we can't understand this, we'll translate the words in the way that it was told to Ameimar, and this is what one should say. Chori Chamimi, hot excrement, Bedikula Bazia, in broken buckets, Lepumaicha, Noshim Dechashayu, should be poured into your mouths, you women who are engaged in witchcraft. Korach Korchayhu, your hairs should be ripped out and cause you baldness. Because they would use these hairs, the Rashbam says that via these hairs, they would do kishuf. Rashi says that as well. Porach Porchayhu, then the crumbs that you use to do kishuf with should fly away. Ivdud Tavlunaichu, and the spices that you use should be scattered. Porcha zika, the wind should blow away. Lemuraika chadata, denoktisu noshim kashfonyos. The wind should blow away these fresh spices that you women who are engaged in witchcraft are holding in your hands. Adachoneini, all the while that Hashem had grace over me and I was gracious to myself, and vechonenchi, and you, as in these koiches atoma, these mazikim, were gracious to me. That all this graciousness caused that loy asisi legoy, that I didn't come in between you. I didn't meet you. But hashta, but now, and this is all part of what you're supposed to say when you meet these women who are the sorceresses. Hashta now da osisi legoy, now that I have met you, it seems that korchanani, it seems that the graciousness of my own graciousness has cooled down, v'chonenchi, and your graciousness towards me has also cooled down. And that's what this is all you're supposed to say to these koichas, to these noshi kashfonios. Continues the Gemara, b'marova loikopti azugi. In Eretz Yisrael, they were not bothered, they were not too concerned about zugos. Rav Dimi min Harada, Kopid of Dimi from Narada was so makbid that afilu arushmo de chavita, when they would have barrels of wine, and every time they would sell some wine, they would make a mark on the barrel to know how much has been left. And he would even make sure there would never be an even amount of marks scratched onto the barrel. Hava uvda, and there was once an incident that he had an even number of these marks on the barrel. Upoka chavita, the barrel just burst. Obviously, because of this, these mazikim that had got hold of the barrel. Klala de mil, so the rule is, kol de kopid, kopti bahadayu. That the more that you give them your makbid and that you're concerned, that's how much they're going to respond to you. Delay kopid, lay kopti bahadayu. But if you're not overly concerned about them, they will not be overly concerned with us. But however, Rashbam says that it doesn't mean that you shouldn't be concerned at all, because if we had the liberty of not being concerned at all, why do we have a whole daf of Gemara? The Gemara should just say, well, don't worry at all about Zugos, there's no issue. And just like wipe out the whole concern, the whole knowledge of them, and they won't bother us. So the Rashbam says, no, you're supposed to be choshesh, one should take care, but one shouldn't be overly concerned. Being overly concerned means that these mazikim are going to be overly concerned with us, and that's dangerous. One's allowed to, and one should be choshesh, one should be a little bit concerned, but not overly. Says the Gemara, Ki Oser Rav Dimi, Omar Shtei Beitzim. Rav Dimi said as follows: eating two eggs, Ushnei Goizim, or eating two nuts, two walnuts, Shtei Kishuim, or eating two vegetables called Kishuim, V'dovar Achir, and one more thing, which he didn't know what that one, he didn't remember what that one thing was. Halacha L'Moshe Misinai, we have Halacha L'Moshe Misinai that there is an issue with Zugos with these four things. There's a discussion in the Mefarshim if this is really Halacha L'Moshe Misinai, or it just means a tradition. Umestapke Luhu L'Rabbonon, the Rabbonon didn't know, my Niu Dover Achir, what was this fourth thing? So they had an issue now. We know there's something that having a double or having two of them is dangerous. We don't know what it is. And therefore, Gozer, Rabbonon, the Rabbonon made a gzeira, Bekulhu Zogi, that all anything that you do in pairs, Mishum Dover Achir, because maybe that one item is this one item, that Halacha L'Moshe Misinai, there's an issue of Zugais. Says the Gemara, V'hada Omron, this that we said before, that Ula said that Asara, and Rav Chisda and Rabba said Tmanyo, 8, and Rabba and Rav Yosef said Shita, 6, Abai and Rava said 4, Ein Arba, with 4, Ein Be Mishum Zugi, and now we say that we have to be concerned. Lo Omron Elo Le'inyon Mazikin. That's only as far as Mazikin are concerned. As far as these powers called Mazikin, there we say that according to different opinions, you do not need to be concerned. Aval inyan kshofim, when there are women around who are doing kishuf, for people who are doing witchcraft, afilo tuva nami chashinon, then even more than 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, even more, one does have to be concerned. Kiha, and this is how the Rashbam explained why Rava, even though Rava said there's no issue of zugos more than two, nonetheless with Arba Koisus he had an issue. Because the Zuga is the regular issue with Mazikim, we don't have according to Rava. But when there's Kishufim around, then there's an issue. So Rava says, how can the Chachomim say everybody should drink 4 cups of wine? There may be an issue of these Kishufim. So Rava said, since one of them is Birchas Hamazon, then there's no issue. Continues the Gemara. Kiha Dahu Gavra. There was an incident with this man, the Garashol de Bisu, that he divorced his wife. And Ozil Intsva, and this divorced woman went and got married lechonvoa to a shopkeeper. Kol yoima hava Ozil, the first husband would come every day, v'shosi chamra, and drink wine in the shop of the second husband. Hava ka'ovda leik shofim. And the woman, that means the ex-wife of this visitor, who's now the wife of the shop owner, she tried every day to harm her first husband using kshofim. And she couldn't manage. He made sure when he was drinking wine never to drink in pairs, so the witchcraft couldn't hurt him. One day, he drank a lot of wine. He didn't remember how many he had drunk. Till 16 cups, his mind was still clear and he knew he was keeping count. V'izdair b'nafshe, he was careful to make sure to not stop at an even number. Mikan v'eilech, but after 16, lo yavetzayil, his mind was not so lucid anymore. V'lo yizdair nafshe, and he wasn't so careful anymore, he couldn't keep count with the drink cups he was drinking. Afikdein, he went out bazuga, having drunk an even number of cups. Ki hava ozil, And when he was going, Gospe, which means either met him or understood from him, Hahu Taya, this traveler, this wanderer, met him or saw him and understood from this person, then Omaleh, and he said to this person, Gavruch Tila Hu Da'ozel Hocha, there's a dead man coming here. Ozel, this person, from worry and from sickness and from illness, he went and Chovke Ledikla, he hugged a palm tree, and because of all the kishuf that had applied, that managed to overpower him, tzovach dikla, the palm tree dried out, it became shriveled, upokahu, and this person burst, and he got killed. Continues the Gemara, Omer Bavira, ka'orois, eating two dishes, food from two dishes, v'kikrois, or two loaves, ein be mishum zugois, there's no issue of zugois. So what's the rule? Kolche gomrei bidei adam, anything which is man-made, which a man finishes off, which is the dishes, which is things he's cooked, or making bread, where he takes the grains and he does the whole process to make a loaf of bread that's been finished by a person, a human being. Ein be mishum zugois, there's no issue of zugois. Gomru bidei shemayim, if it's something like fruits and vegetables which are made and completed by Hashem, then b'mili minei demechel, with food items, chai shinon, then one has to be careful. The Mefarshim discuss why wine, which is the whole sugi we've had till now, the concept of zugois, with drinking wine, why wine is not considered gomru bidei adam, why it's considered gomru bidei shemaim. Continues the Gemara, chanut, if somebody either drinks in two shops, or he drinks two cups in one shop, it's two different explanations in Rashi, ein be mishum zugois, there's no issue of zugois. Nimlach, if a person drank one cup and didn't intend to drink a second cup, and then he drank a second cup, he changed his mind and drank a second cup, ein ben mishum zugois, there's no issue of zugois. Oireach, a guest who doesn't know if he's going to get another cup of wine, then every wine he drinks is as if he's, so to speak, changed his mind and is now receiving a new first cup, ein ben mishum zugois, there's no issue of zugois. Isha, a woman, ein ba mishum zugois. Since a woman, it's not common, and she shouldn't be drinking wine. So even if she drinks one cup of wine, it's not common that she should drink another cup. And if she drinks a second cup, it's as if she changed her mind. It's as if nimlach, and therefore there's no issue of zugois. Vi isha chashuva. However, if she's a prominent woman, then it's more common for her to drink a second cup of wine, chai shinon, than when she drank the first cup. She may have known that she was going to drink a second cup, and therefore there is an issue of zugois. Continues the Gemara, Omer of Chinen Abreder of Yeshua, Ispargus, a very healthy and medically therapeutic drink made of cabbage and water that they would drink in the morning. And since the essence of this drink was refua, was healing, therefore mitztarif l'toivah v'ein mitztarif l'ra, then they will never combine to make an even number. If it's an odd number, it's an odd number. And if it's an even number, then the last one will not combine with the rest to make a subtotal of an even number. Omer Ravina, Mishmei Derava, Zuga L'chumra. If you have a sofik, you have a doubt, did I drink two cups or three cups? If there's two cups, there's a danger. If there's three cups, it's okay. What should you do? L'chumra. Ravina said, in the name of Rav, you should be machmir, and you should have another cup. Why? Because, so Rashi explains that if he had two before, then now he wants this one to be combined with those ones, and therefore it's considered three, and he'll be saved. However, if he only had one cup or three cups before he didn't have zugois, then he doesn't want this cup to be combined, and then it's just considered as if nimlach, as if he's changed his mind to have another cup, and nimlach, we know, is not mitztarif. That was one opinion in the name of Rava. Some say zugei lekula, that if you have a doubt whether you drank two cups or not, or two or an even number of cups, you should be mekel and you should not drink another cup. Why? Because if you drink another cup, it shows that you're concerned, you're overly concerned about zugois, and if you're overly concerned, then in the event that you didn't drink zugois lekatchila, now you make it zugois, you're at risk. However, if you just ignore it, then even if you did drink zugois, you're not showing too much concern, then we can hope that the mazikim will not harm the person. Continues the Gemara, Omer of Yosef, Trei de Chamra. If somebody drinks two cups of wine, v'chad de shichra, one cup of beer, lo mitztarif, then it's not mitztarif, and it's considered zugois. This third cup, being of beer, does not save this person from having drunk the zugois of wine. Trei de shichra v'chad de chamra. But if he drinks two cups of beer and then a third cup, which is of wine, mitztarif, they combine, and it's no longer zugois. How are you supposed to know or remember that wine is mitztarif combined with beer, but beer does not combine with wine? For simonech, I'll give you a simon to this from a Mishnah elsewhere. We know that in Hilchas Tumah, for a piece of material to be able to be Mekabel Tumah, it has to be a certain size. So the Mishnah says in Kelim, Perich of Zayin, that something made of mapats, then the size is 5 tvochim by 5 tvochim. If it's made of machzeles, it's 6 tvochim by 6 tvochim. So what happens if you have machzeles, which only becomes tome if you have 6 tvochim by 6 tvochim? But you only had 5 tvochim of machzeles, and you combine with it, you attach to it, a 1 tefach of mapats. So there we say, since mapats is more stringent, is more chomor than machzeles, proof is that mapats becomes tome with 5 tvochim, machzeles needs 6. Since it's more chomor, it can combine with the machzeles, being the 6th tefach for machzeles. However, the other way around, not if you have mapats of 4 tvochim and it only becomes tamei with 5 tvochim, and you take 1 tefach of machzeles then and you combine it with the 4 of mapats, it doesn't combine. Since the machzeles is more lenient than mapats, it doesn't combine to complete the shiur of 5 tvochim of mapats. And that's what the Mishnah says. Zeh HaKlal, the rule is, Kol Shemuchubur Loi Min HaChomer Mimenu, if what you attach to the original material is more stringent than the halachas of the original material, Tomei. They combine, and now it can become Tomei. Min HaKal Mimenu, but if you combine it with something which is more lenient, Tohir, it will not yet receive the status of being a material that can be Mekabel Tuma. The same is here. Since wine is more choshuv, more prominent than beer, it can be combined with beer. Beer being of lesser value, lesser prominence than wine, the beer will not combine with the wine. Continues the Gemara, Omer of Nachman, Omar Rav. Trei, if somebody drinks two cups of wine, kamotaka, before he starts his meal. Taka means the table, but before the meal. V'chad ataka, and then a third one at the meal. Mitztarfa, they combine, and there's no issue of zugois. Chad mikamo tako, if you drank one cup before the meal, utrea tako, and two during the meal, lo mitztarfinon, then they do not combine. Maskiflor of Masharshia. Masharshia didn't understand this. He says, Otu anan nitkune tako kobinon. Are we considered in the table? Are we caring about the table, about the meal? No. Nitkune gavrabinon. All we need is to make sure the person is safe. The gavra commit kan vekoye. And this person drank three cups. What's the difference if he drank one before the meal, one during the meal? What's the difference? Continues the Gemara. This is all Rabbi Masharshia says, the kule alma, everybody agrees. Trei atako, if you drank two cups of wine during the meal, v'chad lebosar atako, and one after the end of the meal, that's already very different. Before the meal, the wine you drink before the meal is for the meal. It's an appetizer for the meal. And therefore, Rav Masharshia says it combines with the cups that you drank in the meal. But if you have two cups during the meal and one after the meal, lo mitztarfa, they do not combine. Ki ahi maisa de Rabbi Bar Nachmeni. The Gemara says, in Bob Metzia, there was an issue with Rabbi Bar Nachmeni that somebody drank zugais and he got hurt. And he said, you want to heal this person, make sure you continue the meal, because they had already removed the table. And he said to them, bring the table back and continue the meal and drink another cup of another drink, and then it will not be zugais, he'll be healed. Why didn't he just say, drink another cup? Why was it so important for him to continue the meal? So you see from here that if you drink zugois during a meal and another cup after the meal, it does not help for zugois, and therefore he had to continue the meal, and that's what it means. That was the incident with Rabbi Bar Nachmeni. Continues the Gemara, Omer of Yehuda Mashmuel, Kol HaMozug, any types of drinks which are diluted. For example, wine, is diluted with water. Then other drinks are diluted. Since if you drink a number of diluted drinks, since they're all diluted, they have something in common, it's considered a single type, and there's an issue of zugos. Mitztaref, they combine with each other to create a problem and to solve the problem of zugos. Chutz min hamayim, according to this first opinion, according to Shmuel, water, if you dilute water with water, it's not considered diluted, and therefore it wouldn't be part in the same of diluted drinks. Rabbi Yechanan says, afilu mayim, even water in some cases could be considered diluted. When Omer of Papa, Rav Papa explains, Lo Omron, this Rabbi Yechanan said that water is considered diluted, is elo chamimi legoi kriri, if you're pouring hot water into cold water, or kriri legoi chamimi, or if you're pouring cold water into hot water, then it's considered a mixture of different waters, and it's considered diluted and is a similar type to other diluted drinks. Aval chamimi ligoy chamimi, if you pour hot water into hot water, v'kariri ligoy kariri, or cold water into cold water, loy, then it's not considered as being a mixture, as being combined, and therefore it would not combine with other diluted drinks. And in Mirtz Hashem, in the next shir, we're going to continue from here.